God lives and works today. But perhaps you don't feel that way because you are sick or suffering. Would you like to discover how your suffering can actually bring you closer to God? Yes, even make you happy and joyful. Today's meditation is a testimony from the life of Basilea Schlink, which shares how she made this exciting discovery. She writes about a time when she was seriously ill, but not alone in suffering. She writes,
I was separated from my loved ones for a long time owing to my illness. Even while I was at home, I seldom saw them because the doctor had ordered complete rest and few visitors. When I was taken to the hospital, I lay almost completely alone for several months. But now I will tell you a secret. I was not really alone. One day a nurse brought me a cross and hung it on the wall opposite my bed. It was a great help in reminding me of the sufferings of our Lord Jesus. He, who is love, suffered endless pain beneath his crown of thorns because he loves me. So I was strengthened and my faith renewed. Jesus is with me. He loves me more than anyone else could. He has suffered and wept for me more than anyone else has, and today he still suffers with me, for he is the living Lord. I could talk to him at any time and could tell him what was in my heart. Yes, I could bring him all my needs and the questions that troubled me. He understands them and answers them better than any person. Yes, I look to him who bears God's image, Jesus. He is entirely merciful and humble. He is peace. As I look to him, I experience the truth of Psalm 34, verse 5. Look to him and be radiant, so your face shall never be ashamed. A deep peace entered my heart, and I was deeply comforted. So my illness, in all its misery, was changed into a time of blessing, full of peace and joy in him. If your illness is keeping you from all work and activity, then the time has come for God to work in you and create new things. When you are unable to do anything, God is able to do great things in you. Also, he will use this time of illness to bring you closer to himself, if you will let him. Therefore, accept your suffering. Say, Yes, Father, thy will be done, and he will do great things in you now, and later you will become a channel of his blessing to others.
I praise the blessing, the birth confessing, the pass of pain and darkest night. God's will is goodness and loving kindness, so good the ways by which he leads. So praise the
You've been listening to a program written by Basilea Schlink of the Little Land of Canaan. If this program has been a help to you, we would be happy to send you a free leaflet by the same author. Please write to God Lives and Works Today, 9849 North 40th Street, Phoenix, Arizona, 85028-4099. That's God Lives and Works Today, 9849 North 40th Street, Phoenix, Arizona, 85028-4099. God bless you.